Hi everyone, hope you're okay. We are going to do some more guitar lesson today, and if you've been practicing, well done on the Another One Bites the Dust and Lily the Pink. That's great news to hear, and you will be getting better. If you've had a busy week, don't worry. If you want to go over the last video, we're going to just play, because I enjoy it so much, Another One Bites the Dust, just part of it. And if anyone wants to show them what they've been doing, send me a WhatsApp video, fine, text, any emails would be greatly appreciated. I'd love to hear from you. Today is very rainy, it's not nice at all. I've been stuck in, I'm a bit worried that we're going to get flooded in our stables. We have two donkeys, as you know, two Shetland ponies. And I was hoping to do one of our lessons with the donkeys in it. I was gonna play outside. And play guitar, some songs for you. But anyway, hopefully that'll happen in the next few weeks, but definitely not today, because I think we're going to get flooded. And today is a girl I teach, she's 18. So I think she's going to be stuck in as well on her 18th today. Not a very good day to have your 18th, is it, in lockdown? So we'll start with the E string. This is the sixth string. Do you remember the strings went 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, backwards. And this is the E string, and the E looks like this, capital E, backwards. Do you remember? The five lines of music, that's called the stave. And this is a one beat note. 1, 2, and this lasts for 3, 4. So because that lasts for two counts on 3 and 4, that's a two beat note. That's got a white middle. That's why it's got a white middle, because it lasts longer than these two. Okay, so let's play I Like Chips. Ready? I like chips. You ready again? I like chips. Stop. Then we'll do it again. I like chips. Now, if you've practiced it enough, you will be able to keep up with them. So, shall we have a go? I've just turned it up a bit. Ready? I like chips. I like chips. I like chips. I like chips. That carry on playing through it, put YouTube on, play through. Now we're going to learn another note today. This one takes quite a lot of strength, so we need our first finger. We're going to be on the E string, and we need our first finger, and we're going to press. It's hard, this, so you do need a lot of strength, be careful. You're going to press the sixth string, the thick one, the first box. And we're going to put our finger up to the metal, up to nearly box two. Now, because I'm not with you, I know some of you, we're going to get some funny sounds to begin with. This is box one. And when we pluck the note, we have to actually press it and pluck at the same time. So you have to squeeze it down. Okay, now if it sounds like this, and funny and buzzy, or like that, what you've got to do is make sure that you're not there. Mine's buzzing now. Can you hear that? I'm pressing really hard, mine's buzzing. So you've got to go up to nearly box two. Press it. And you've got to really pin it down. You've got to really press it hard. And then pluck the string. All right. If you just sit on it and the string isn't touching the wood, you'll get that sound. So it's just a little bit of getting used to. You might get this sound for a while. Just ask Mum, Dad, whoever's with you, just to maybe press your finger down a little bit. Yeah, don't scream. Please don't scream. We'll push that finger down and pluck it like that. Okay. So this note's called F. Now, F on the music looks like, just see if you can see what's happened with the F. Think of the alphabet. E, and after the alphabet, sorry, after E in the alphabet is F. So there's an E. Can you see what's happened with that little bobble there, that little round circle? It's travelled from underneath that line there, that third line. And it's just travelled up to the next line. Like in the alphabet, when we travel up from E to F, don't we? When we say the alphabet, we go from E to F. So from E to F on a note, that little bobble is just going to go up and it just has the line cutting through the middle of it. There. Okay, it's just risen up a little bit and it's gone to the higher note. So that's a low note. And this F's a tiny bit higher on the music and it's higher in sound on the guitar. Now what's good about these two notes is you can, if you play E, F, E, F, you can play Jaws. So have you all heard of Jaws? Go on, tell me what's Jaws. Who is he? Anyone not know? Ask your mum. Jaws goes like this. And it'll take a bit of time. What we do is you go slow, E, and then you put F on. And you have to press the note before you pluck it. Right, keep it down, don't let it up. Yeah, don't let it escape. And then E, I'll play it a bit faster to show you what you can do if you practice. I'm getting gradually louder. That's the scary. So, do you want to just have a little go putting the F on, everyone? First finger, press it, and if I'm going too fast, stop the video. Okay, pause it. You just practice putting the finger on. Ask for some help if you hurt your fingers or if you're getting a buzz. You keep as you want to try it. But she's got enough to do though, actually. Don't put F on and pluck the string like that. Practice E to F. I'll just do it first. E, and then you put your finger on. Only when you've pressed, you pluck again while it's pressed. Don't let it down. As soon as you let it up, it goes. Comes off. As soon as you let go, you've got to keep it pressed. Okay, should we do it together slowly? If you can't keep up, please stop the video. E. First finger on, F, take it off, go back to E, take this one off, E, put your first finger on F, F, take the F and go to E, E, F, put your finger on, first finger, F for first finger, F, first finger. F. Okay, let me play some Jaws. Here it is, it's just set right. See if you can hear that now. Mm-hmm. On for about a minute and 40 seconds, so I won't play it all the way through. Just doing that, something's happening, isn't it? I fast forward it. don't know, I'm whispering. Fast, you don't need to go that fast yet. It's finished. All right. Okay. Well done, everybody. So we've learnt two notes now, E and F on the music. That's fabulous. And you know where to press the F note. Your fingers will hurt. And after practicing, you'll get hard skin on the ends, okay? I remember wanting to give up the guitar when I started learning. I remember coming home saying I wanted to give up because my fingers really hurt at the ends. And my mum said, you can't give up because of that, because everybody give up then. It hurts everyone to begin with. And now I've got really hard skin on the ends of my fingers. It doesn't hurt at all. For all these musicians you hear on telly, they don't start sitting there going, ah, in the middle of a band, do they? Going, oh. No, okay, it doesn't hurt after a while if you keep practicing. All right, so good luck with this sheet. Now we're going to go over to, shall we just play the first verse, chorus and first verse of Lily the Pink, if you listen to that one. I'll just go over that. So if you get your music. Introduction. Okay, are you ready? And get to young purple and copy off me. That maybe play last week's video and then you can play all the three verses. Now then, I've got sheet 17 here and sheet 18. Now sheet 17 is he's got the whole world in his hands, and quite often when we get back and we have assemblies or we play for class, might be a class worship, it might be a class assembly, we get asked to play this song. Skills you enjoy singing this song. He's got the whole world in his hands. Now, I think most schools sing it. There might be the odd one, but I'll teach it if they don't. And when we play this song, we've got to be really careful that we only strum at certain times. It's very tempting to strum out of time for it, because the way we sing it makes us rush when we sing, and it makes us nearly go out of time. So I'll play a bit for you and then I'll break it down, all right, slowly, so you just listen to me first. You don't need to go this fast. He's got the whole strum world in his hands. He's got the whole wide world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the wind and the rain in his hands. He's got Hopefully rings a bell with you. Now, when we strum it, don't worry if you get into it like this a bit. Alright, that's just going to be the strength of your fingers. Remember, go up to the metal line there. And then that finger goes on there, in the middle. Okay. And when we strum, don't strum all the strings. Alright, just strum those four. Alright. And you will get this sound eventually. A7 will sound lovely. Do a string check, do you remember? Bottom string, like that. So, when we strum it, it starts off on D on whole. And this particular song is called, it's got an anacrusis beginning. And in music, that means it doesn't start on the first word. So if our songs start our chord on the first word, okay, that's great. But this one's called an anacrusis beginning because we start singing first. Okay, it doesn't start on a complete bar. It's called in music. So it will go, he's got the, and then we strum on world, whole, sorry. He's got the whole strum, world strum. So we have to keep this pulse going. All right, like this. Keep the beat going. Ready, so we don't just stop strumming when we stop singing, we keep the pulse going. Ready, so copy off me slowly, we'll do it very slow. We're on purple. He's got the whole strum, world strum. In his hands, he's got the, I exaggerated that, the, we don't strum on the. We change now on whole. Whole wide world in his hands, he's got the, change again now to purple. Whole strum, world strum in his hands, he's got the, let's go to blue. Whole world in his strum, so that's quite hard. Whole world in his strum. Should do that one more time. Whole world from blue. Whole world in his strum. After you've said his, purple. Hands, strum, strum. Should we just do that part again? So when I say he's got the, we don't strum on the. And when we say whole, we change, all right, on the whole for the chorus. Right, okay. Should we go again from the chorus? He's got the whole strum, world strum, in his hands. He's got the whole strum. Yes. one. Now we'll go on to verse one, okay? And then we go, he's got the winds and the rain in his hands, he's got the wind and the rain in his hands, he's got the pebble, wind and he's got the whole world strong in his hands, he's got the whole wide world in his hands, he's got the whole strong world strong in his hands. More verses, but I think your fingers will want to rest now, aren't they, from playing? Well done. Okay, if your thumb hurts, you can get plectrums. They're very, very cheap on the internet, and you can get, I bring in thumb plectrums, so if anybody wants a thumb plectrum, it just fits around your thumb and you can strum with that, because I do know you will get a blister with keeping on strumming. But if you get a blister, I know it doesn't sound like it, but it is good news, because eventually the blister does pop and you end up with hard skin and it doesn't hurt anymore. I could keep strumming all day and night and it won't hurt. So after a while, you do get hard skin, but I've also got a nail. So that's my own like self-made plectrum. I can use that when I play, when I do finger picking. Done, everybody, that was great. Now if you need to go over it, that's fine. The rhythm's hard, you've a lot of tasks to do all at once. You're changing with this hand, you are strumming, you are sometimes having to look what you're doing, you're reading, you're also looking where to change chord. There's a lot to do all at once, so you are really multitasking. Well done. Now, I've got another song. This is called The Big Ship Sails on the Alley Alley O. And when we get back, we usually go and play for the reception with all these songs that we're doing. So they really enjoy it, but at the moment we can't. But soon as we can, we're getting a real good collection of songs to play for them. And usually at Easter we do go and play. We take an Easter card. I usually take a cake for the teacher. they usually eat it while we play for them and for the class. We take a nice Easter plate in. So we'll see how we go on, but we will be doing it at some point. So we've got quite a few songs now that we're getting. And nurseries, we go and play for the nursery at school. So yeah, we can look forward to that. We're still going, we're still managing to keep it up. So keep strumming, everyone. Okay, at the end of the song on the big ship, I've given you some ideas. I've put, if you want to play verse one, when you get used to it, forte. Forte means, in music, loud. It's an Italian word for loud, forte. If you want to play, you have to say these posh, piano. Piano means quietly, softly. So it's not piano that we play, it's piano. And piano means soft. Okay, so I've given you some suggestions when you're playing yourself. You could play the first verse, forte, start off. Verse two, piano. Okay, verse three, forte. And alternate it like that. Okay, right. So it's just DNA 7 again, and we are getting so much better at changing these. Any choruses in this, okay? Just verses, five verses. I'll do an intro. Oh, the big ship sails on the alley, alley, oh, the alley, alley, oh, the alley, alley, oh. Oh, the big ship sails on the alley, alley, oh. A storm blew up in the middle of the night. A storm blew up in the middle of the night on the last day of September. The ship, it sank without a single trace, without a single trace, without a single trace. The ship, it sank single trace on the last day of September. We'll dip our heads in the bright blue sea, sorry, the deep blue sea, the deep blue sea. We'll dip our heads in the deep blue sea on the last day of September. Okay. Anyone know that one? Some? I think mums and dads will know it. Sisters, brothers. Now, when we play this one, we have to be really careful. Have you got the sheet in front of you? We start again on an anacrusis beginning on big. Oh, the big. It's a little intro, yeah? Oh, the big ship sails on the alley, alley, oh, strum. And after we say, strum, the, we don't strum on the word the. I think we should just try tapping it first, shall we? Are you ready? Alright, let's tap the rhythm. Oh, the big ship sails on the alley, alley, oh. Tap the alley, alley, oh. Tap the the big ship sails on the alley, alley, oh, on the last day of September. Strum, the strum. So that goes, tem, strum, the strum. Shall we just tap one more? Oh, it sailed away on the bright blue sea. Tap. Bright blue sea, tap, bright blue sea, oh, it sailed and so on. Okay, should we try it together? Let's put D on. I'll tell you where to change if you want to watch me on the video, or you can watch your sheet. I'll do my intro again. Difficult to keep up to. We just have to practice changing from purple to blue, and it will be hard if you are struggling changing from purple to blue. So if you can get that sorted, you will be able to do the songs no problem. That's the hard bit, changing, and the changing will not take you that long. Okay, some of the high school children I teach have decided to do a bit of a practice challenge. And usually, some of them getting home from school takes them 20 minutes, half an hour on the school bus. So they said, because they're at home already, they're not having to make the journey home, in that time that they've got now spare, because when they finish school, they're already at home, they don't have to travel to get home, they started practicing the guitar in that time, because we're in anyway. And I can't tell you how they've improved. There are about four of them, and they're having a bit of a, they call it the bus challenge. And instead of being, obviously, like this long journey home, they are practicing the guitar instead while they're at home, when they should usually be on the bus. And their practice has done them the world of good. They are playing amazingly, just in nearly 2 weeks. So keep the practice going, everybody. I'll show you something guitar-y that I've already got in here before I go. All right, we'll say bye-bye. and we will see you next week. And if we get a sunny day, I'm hoping to play my guitar outside and we can have a sing song outside with the donkeys. Okay, bye everybody, stay safe, let me know how you're getting on. Bye.